What's going on, guys? Welcome back to the channel. So once we're getting some pretty decent weather out here in Florida.
So I think today's going to be the perfect day to get in the car, go for a drive, and talk about the new 2021 Bronco. I believe it was last Friday, they finally released the build-in price for it, and I can't express how excited I am after seeing it. So let's go ahead and get a cold start up on the car. All right, so let's go ahead and get talking about this Bronco. So Ford had announced that you were gonna be able to get the Sasquatch package for the base model. I immediately said, I'm getting it. The fact that you can get the base model car with the Sasquatch package meant that you didn't have to spend much to be able to get it. So for those of you that don't know, some of the trims have rubber floors with a drain plug, but it's not gonna be available on all of them. The first trim level that is going to be available with the rubber floor is the black diamond. That's going to be the third tier of the trims. And that kind of put a hole in my plan, because my plan was, I was convincing myself to get a complete base model, get the Sasquatch package, and call it a day with that. But don't really want the carpet flooring. That was kind of a downer for me. I really wanted to go ahead and get that rubber flooring ever since Doug Jaburo made that video of his, when they gave him a dummy car to look at. When I saw that, I was like, whoa, I didn't even know that was a thing until he said it in the video. So I really changed my mind with it, because I as soon as Doug mentions that it was going to be available on some trims, immediately the first thing I did was I went to go look at that brochure that they had with all the trim levels, and I was like, okay, what is it going to be an option on? Because I missed it before. That's when I realized that the black diamond was going to be the one that I had to go with. And this was one thing I didn't like about the build-in price, was it doesn't flat out tell you, hey, this has the rubberized floor, this doesn't, whatever. You have to look at the compare vehicles brochure that they have separately. So I had to, I was going back and forth between these two things. So I was chatting with my buddy and I was like, hey, I optioned out my black diamond model, and it came out to $46,000. And he stops me and says, do you realize that's the price of a Wild Track? Kind of stopped me in my tracks right there. So then I go and I pull up the Wild Track. So what I didn't know about the Wild Track is it includes the Sasquatch package. It includes the medium tech package. And I believe it includes the 2.7 liter EcoBoost. So everything that I wanted for the Bronco was included in the Wild Track. But then there's a downside to it. The Wild Track comes with cloth seats and carpet floors. I was confused. I don't understand. Why not just, I don't know if that's like where they're trying to get people to like split between the trim levels, I'm not sure. That made me take a look at it, and I saw that the Badlands comes with the rubber floor as well as marine grade vinyl seats. That's when I realized that's the trim level that I'm gonna have to go for. So finally got things figured out. So I'm gonna get the Badlands with the Sasquatch package with the 2.3 liter. So I think the biggest thing that shocked everyone was the price of the Sasquatch package. I really thought it was gonna be close to $10,000. So if you look at the package itself, it says like $4,500, if I'm not mistaken. I gotta double check that. But I believe it said $4,500 for the package. But it's not $4,500, guys. Once you try to add it to your vehicle, it's like $6,000. Still, better than I anticipated. I really thought it was gonna be more expensive than that. So that was kind of why, where I was before they had released the build-in price. I was kind of like, okay, well, what are we going to do about it if it's not that much? I really thought I was going to be going with a base model, and then sure enough, they reeled me in with candy. They were like, but we have this. At the moment that I saw that there was the rubberized floors, I said, all right, yep, I can't get a base model anymore. So I could really use you guys' help. I'm trying to decide. I've narrowed it down to three colors for my Bronco. I'm really leaning towards, the color I'm leaning towards a little bit is the Area 51 color. I'll put up a picture of it now. The second color I'm kind of looking at is the flagship color, the Cyber Orange. I think it looks pretty cool. I think it'd be an awesome color to have on there. So that one's a top contender as well. And the third color I'm looking at is the Velocity Blue. All three of those colors look pretty awesome. I like them. I'm kind of struggling choosing between the three of them. So comment below. Let me know which color you guys think I should go with my Bronco. So the next thing I've got to tackle on the car is I need to get some brakes and rotors done for the car. I was looking online trying to find them and got to get those ordered soon. So I'll have a video of putting those on the car very, very soon. I just got to get those parts ordered and find some time to put them on. Dude, that supercharger, oh my goodness. Just the moment you hear it, it's like, ah! You just want to keep going, but can't do that. Guys, let me know what you think of the new Bronco. Is it really going to be worth getting it? Do you guys plan on getting one for yourself? I hope you guys already have an order in, because last I heard, there's about 165,000 orders out there, so it might be a while. I'm thinking that I won't get the car until December, possibly not until 2022, honestly, just because of the time frame that that we're looking at for them to be built, getting built. All right, guys, thank you so much for watching. I really appreciate every moment that you guys are spending watching my videos. It really does mean a lot to me. Please be sure to subscribe and like this video and turn on those bell notifications so you know when the next video's on, and I'll catch you guys in the next video.